वेलकम फ्रेंड्स एंड वेलकम टू माय सीरीज ऑफ वीडियो लेक्चर्स ऑन थियरी ऑफ स्ट्रक्चर्स। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद द प्रॉब्लम व्हिच वी हैव स्टार्टेड इन द लास्ट वीडियो ऑन द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ मेंबर फोर्सेस बाय मेथड ऑफ जॉइंट्स। वी आर स्टडीइंग द टॉपिक ऑफ सिंपल ट्रसेस इन रिलेशन टू द कोर्स आउटकम एफ, इवेल्युएट एक्सियल फोर्सेस इन मेंबर्स ऑफ सिंपल ट्रसेस। So we are solving a numerical problem on calculation of member forces in a given frame. In step 1, in the last video, we have seen that we have to calculate support reactions for simply supported frames. So we have already calculated the support reaction as RAX, RAY and RC. In step 2, we have to apply the method of joints for calculation of member forces. In the last video, we have analyzed joint A and we have found out the member forces in member AB as 8.73 and member AD as 2.81 kN. We have also noted the values of forces in this table. Now we have to continue with finding out the forces in the other members. We know that totally there are 7 members and we have found out 2 member forces. One joint A has given us values of 2 forces. Now we have to go for the next joint to get values of 2 more member forces. Now as we have seen in the last video, the choice of a joint is to be made with the condition that at that joint there should be maximum 2 unknown forces. So now let us look at joint D for example. At joint D, there are 3 forces, DA, DB and DE. There is no external force, but these 3 are internal forces. Out of these 3 forces, DA force is 2.81 kN, which is already calculated in the last joint. That is why the unknown forces are only 2, DE and DB. So we can very well consider joint D for analysis. So, let us start with joint D. So, let us draw the free body diagram of joint D. So, this is joint D. We have got one force like this, another force like this, and third force like this. Now, the arrow tip for this force is already obtained. So we don't have any choice. It is already this. So we don't have to assume anything. This is 2.81 kN. Now this is DE. So we will call this as FDE. And this is FDB. These two are unknown forces. So we will assume their directions as outward, away from the joint. So this is the free body diagram of joint D. Now we require one more detail in this. That detail is regarding the angle. We need the angle. So the angle will be calculated like this. This is the vertical reference. We will call this angle as phi and this angle also as phi. They are equal because this is an equilateral triangle. So, last time we had assumed this angle as theta. Now we will take this angle as phi and this angle also as phi. Now what will be the value of phi? If you consider this triangle D, this and this, this right angle triangle, you know this theta is already calculated. So this phi will be, angle phi will be 90 degrees minus theta. So this will be 90 degrees minus the earlier value of 63.43 degrees. So this value will be, this final value will be 26.57 degrees. So this is the value of phi. Now we will continue to solve this joint. So to solve this joint or to analyze this joint means to do what? Apply conditions of equilibrium. That's all. So we will apply the first condition, sigma fx equal to 0. For this we will assume the sign convention as the rightward force is positive. So if we apply the sign convention and sigma fx equal to 0 condition, then we can see that in these three forces, this force is already in x direction. So it will come as it is. So this is FDE. It is already towards right direction. So according to sign convention, it will be plus FDE. Even though it is plus, you should write that plus sign also so that it is more clear to you. Then the next thing is this FDB force. This FDB force is inclined. So it will have an x component as well as y component. So x component of FDB will be FDB into sine phi. Sine phi. Now the arrow tip of the sine component or the x component will be towards right. So it will be taken as plus. Then 2.81 kN, this is the third force, it is also inclined, so it will have an x component and y component. So x component of this 2.81 kN will be 2.81 into sine phi again. It is this phi angle for this component and its arrow tip is like this. So for this, this arrow tip will go away from the joint. So it will be towards left, so it will be minus and this will be equal to 0. According to condition sigma fx equal to 0. Now you can see that in this equation there are two unknown quantities. So we will have to keep this equation as it is for the time being and then I will just call this as equation 1. Now we will apply the next condition of equilibrium, that is sigma Fy equal to 0. When we are using the equation, we have to specify the sign convention also. The upward forces in y direction means upward forces will be treated as positive. Now let us apply the condition. Look at again all the three forces and consider their y components. If you consider this FDE, its y component is 0. It is already horizontal in x direction. Then this FDB is inclined, so it will have a y component also. So its y component will be FDB into cos of phi. Then that y component, it will be directed downwards because it is, this is away from this. So this will also be away from the joint and it will be directed downwards. So its sign will be minus. The third force is 2.81 kN and it is its y, it is inclined or oblique. So it will have a y component and that y component will also be 2.81 cos of phi and it will be minus because it is also acting downwards. So these are the two y components of two forces. So this will be equated to 0. So this becomes our second equation. If you see in this equation there is only one unknown, so you can very well calculate the value directly. So that value will be, as we can, as I have already calculated, this FDB will be equal to minus 2.81 kN. Minus 2.81 kN. Let us put this in a box. But we have to understand the significance of this minus sign. What is the meaning of this minus sign? In all the calculations, whenever we get a minus answer, it only means that the direction which you assumed, it should be reversed. The direction you assumed was wrong and you had to change the direction. So when you have assumed direction of this FDB as away from this joint. So now this minus sign is telling us that this direction was wrong and you should reverse that direction. In such a case, we have to remove this and you have to show the direction like this. The real direction is like this. Now here I want to give you a small tip that in the exam or in your notebook also, these assumed directions should be shown by pencil so that you can erase them and show the corrected directions. Otherwise, you will have to show two directions and that will create a lot of confusion. It is good for me that I can wipe out by duster, but if you use a pen, then it will be a difficulty for you. So this is the meaning of this minus sign and that makes the change there. Now we can put this value as it is in equation 1, and therefore from equation 1 we get, in equation 1 you have to put this FDB as minus 2.81, FDB as minus 2.81. So FD plus minus 2.81 into sin phi minus 2.81 sin phi. So that will give you the value of FDE. You please do that calculation yourself and I will tell you finally the answer of that. So the answer of FDE is plus 2.61 kilonewton. So answer of FDE is 2.61 plus kilonewton, and therefore this plus sign indicates that whatever direction we have assumed for FDE is correct. We don't have to reverse that direction. So this has given us now the values of both the member forces. Okay, so FDB, its direction as shown here should be like this. So we will show it like this so that the opposite direction can be shown immediately like this. Each member will have two arrows, equal and opposite. So if you have got this one arrow, then automatically the second arrow you can blindly draw as in the opposite direction. And the value is FDB minus 2. So that minus sign will not come there. This will be 2.81. So this is the value. Then same is the case about DE. Look at DE, it is plus 2.61. Now plus means the assumed direction is correct, so the arrow tip is like this, so it will be shown like this. So this other arrow tip will come like this and the value will be taken as 2.61. Now we will make a note of this in the table also. DB is 2.81. Look at the 2.81, look at the arrow tips here, they are away from each other. So if they are away from each other, they indicate compression. So this is C. Now look at DE. For DE, the force is 2.61. And look at the arrow tips. The arrow tips are towards each other. The arrows are pointing towards each other. So when they are pointing towards each other, it indicates tension in the member. So this is the picture and this is the conclusion of analysis of joint D. So we have now covered four members, three members are remaining. So we will continue in the next video. So friends, we are continuing the same problem in this video and we will have to continue the same problem in the next video also. So goodbye till then. We will meet in the next video.